On September 3rd, we did our final Halloween Horror Nights 26 podcast before the event. We talked all about the meetups, we announced all 8 of them, we gave the RSVP locations, we teased a little bit about some merchandise that's coming throughout the duration of the event, and we ended our podcast with the normal way we do. Very successful event, and we have a lot of people that are very interested in the meetups, and I'll get to that a little bit later in this video. Now, the thing about that is we haven't talked for a while, like one-on-one. We haven't had any one-on-one Owen time yet. We haven't had where I can talk to you guys out there that are watching the videos and have been watching the videos and are the reason that the Popcast Network is consistently successful and has been consistently successful since we started doing Halloween Horror Nights videos and started doing Halloween Horror Nights podcast back in April of last year. I didn't forget you guys. I just kind of got busy. Life gets in the way sometimes. I like to throw that out there. It seems like it's just very cliche, but it's the truth. Life got in the way. And the reason life got in the way is because my plans drastically changed for this year. Not only am I able to go the 3 weeks at the beginning of the event and the 2 days, the second to last week, and all of closing week, I got a little bit of a shock and surprise when I found out that somehow, some way, it was worked out so I could attend the entire event. And I had it okayed with my job, I had it okayed with everyone around me, and sure enough, Halloween Horror Nights 26, I will be there every single night. That's the reason why you're seeing so many meetups this year, because there's availability for myself. I'll be at Spooky Empire this year, and I'll be at Disney this year. I'll get my Disney annual pass back. Obviously, I'll continue my Universal annual pass. I'll be at every night of Halloween Horror Nights, and who knows what awesome things I'm going to be doing in Orlando. I think I'm doing Zombie Outbreak Orlando. That's going to happen. A lot of cool things we're going to be doing. But that's a little bit later. And that's the reason why I've been so busy. That's the reason why it's been 36 days last time we talked until opening night. As of this very moment, it is now 8 days. And for myself, for a lot of the elite, and for a lot of very fortunate friends and team members, it's only 6 days. So in 6 days, we will see Halloween Horror Nights 26 for the very first time. And I'm super excited about it. But again, I'm getting ahead of myself. So let's go back. Go back to last year. Actually, let's go back several years. There's been a constant rumor that American Horror Story was going to come to the event. And then everybody was like, nah, I don't see it. Can it coexist with The Walking Dead? Is Ryan Murphy's laundry list of things he wants in the house, is it too great to be able to topple? Is it, like, insurmountable? Is it, there's a chance it's ever going to happen? And is it too bizarre, too risque, too out there, too violent for Halloween Horror Nights? We would find that answer earlier this year, because there was a lot of rumors, and then it started building and building and building, and eventually it started to feel like it was actually going to happen. And sure enough, it actually did. But we'll get to that momentarily. Now, it officially started on the @HorrorNightsORL Twitter feed on the 15th of last month. And there was a tweet that just came out, like, pretty much out of the blue, that said, ask the right questions, follow good advice. And there was an @TH351VEWS. Yes, it's basically computer speak for the 5 W's. Obviously, I'm a journalism major, or was at one point, and I do know all about the who, what, when, where, how, and why. And that's pretty much what it was. The entire Twitter feed was who, what, when, where, why, and how. Oh, I said how twice, but still, how did I say that twice? So, all the 5 W's, basically, and how, of course, when it comes down to it, every single tweet was pretty much linking to a dictionary.com definition of that word. And it was very repetitive. And it was so repetitive so much that it was actually, like, adding a letter, like, who, like, W-H-O-O. And then, of course, it gave, like, tribute to Ric Flair. It was like, woo! But then again, one of them was where. And the where had, I gotta see how many letters that is, 4, 5, 6, 6 E's. Like, Randy! Like, Aziz Ansari's character from Funny People that he used in a stand-up act. With, like, 8 A's, this had 6 E's. And what it was a link to a media file. I read the wrong word on my notes here. And the media file was a garbled message that was quickly decrypted and decoded on Horror Night Nightmares, because that's what we do. And sure enough, it was like a doorbell, and then it was like a scream, and it literally said, California, Florida, California. Now, a lot of people were taking that as to mean a dual coast announcement. I took that as the fact that we were setting Murder House in California, Freak Show is obviously in Jupiter, Florida, and Hotel, literally, Hotel California. So, yeah, it made sense that it would go both ways. And plus, if you go even deeper into it, you would see that the code itself, hidden within, not really very well, but hidden within the actual coding, were the words AHS, or the letters AHS in this case. So, this was going to happen. And it was finally going to come to fruition. American Horror Story was coming to the event. But how? Now, the rumors were persisting that we were going to be getting a compilation house. And we're going to get every season, all 5 seasons of American Horror Story. And it was going to be done in the same way that Monsters of Mayhem was done last year. It was going to pretty much go from season to season, and then be a couple rooms for each season. That was the rumor that we all heard. Now, eventually, it got down to the fact that they were only going to focus on a few of them. And sure enough, they decided they wanted to focus on the first season, Murder House, and obviously focusing on the season of Freak Show and Hotel, the last 2 seasons. And of course, the new season, which starts on preview night, which we still don't know exactly what the theme is going to be. We have a lot of rumors. Who knows what it's going to be? And we'll probably see that most likely with Asylum and Coven next year, unless they decide they want to split it up. I think that it's pretty positive right now that American Horror Story is replacing The Walking Dead at the event, because I still believe that there is a good possibility that by the end of the event, we will get an official announcement of the closing of Terminator 2 and the opening of the Walking Dead attraction in that spot coming in 2017, or late 2017, early 2018, or pretty much getting it ready for actual Halloween Horror Nights next year. So you can literally do exactly the same thing Hollywood did. You could promote The Walking Dead as kind of a maze, but since it is kind of like the House of Horrors was, it's kind of like it's there, but it's not officially one of the mazes, but it is, if that makes any sense whatsoever. So yeah, that's what I'm thinking is going to happen. We'll see if it does. Now, sinuses is very strange. So, Mike wrote a blog post on the Universal Orlando blog and said, basically, since this fantastic series we've been watching and calculating, if ever given the chance, how we would translate it into a haunted experience. Now, the most engaging thing about American Horror Story, every season is a completely new and different storyline. New environments, new characters, not unlike Halloween Horror Nights. So, they had to decide how to capture into one house. They decided they wanted to do the mega house, the Uber maze, if you will. No money needed, of course, in this case. And they decided to take the template for Monsters of Mayhem, which was the ideal format they wanted to use. We're going to go into the Harmon residence and evade the basement. And we're going to see the roadside freak show. We're going to see Twisty and all the various performers in the freak show. And then we're going to go into Hotel Cortez and unlock the domain of the Countess. So all 3 seasons vividly recreated in great detail. And they worked with Ryan Murphy, and Ryan Murphy apparently approved, because this is actually happening, and it's real this time around. So, that's the interesting thing. And I'll get more to Orlando when we get down to it, but let me talk a little about Hollywood's lineup. John Murdy, very theatrical in his presentation on Twitter, always has been. Goes to at Horror Nights whenever there is going to be a maze announcement and drops the Bill Shakespeare, by the pricking of my thumbs, something wicked this way comes. And that's exactly what announced American Horror Story was coming to Hollywood just the same. It says your journey begins at the infamous Murder House, a century-old residence on the outskirts of LA with a tragic past. and the unfortunate souls who perish inside the haunted house, forever trapped within its walls. Each room harbors a terrible secret. Then the creepy backwater town of Jupiter, Florida, where the freak show has taken up its residence. Human oddities on display inside the Big Top, nothing compared to the murderous men and women who fight to control it. And then finally, you will check into Hotel Cortez, the ruinous relic of a bygone era that conceals a torture chamber of murder and madness. Inside the hotel's haunted hallways lies a host of supernatural characters bent on making you a guest for all eternity. Very haunted mansion. So, yeah, this is going to be located in the Metro sets in Hollywood, where From Dusk Till Dawn was for 2014, and is going to be much bigger than a typical maze in Hollywood. Now, I will state right now, it's probably taking the Uber maze template, but they're, like, shrinking it a little bit given the size they have. It's a Metro set, so I think it's probably going to work really well. So, last night, I have something in my throat, it's really rude. There we go. Last night, members of the media got to go through both American Horror Story and Krampus in Hollywood. And I saw on Twitter a couple of things that were posted. We go through the murder house, we see the basement, and there's the burnt room, which I've seen images of. It looks very freaky, very muted tones. There's no safe haven for the guests. How appropriate. And we're going in a freak show. The facade, they're not letting anybody take pictures of it yet. So the only thing that the media actually got were the various carnival banners. So you got to see, like, the bearded lady, and you got to see a stupid thing in my mouth. It was very random. Sorry for doing that, but I had to because it was driving me nuts. I don't want to do this for another, like, 40 minutes, especially with that in my mouth. Now we're done with that, so we're done. So you got to see the freak show. You got to see all the inhabitants of the freak show and, like, various characters, like the Siamese twins and everything. Obviously, I probably should tell you, if you don't know already, I don't know much about American Horror Story other than what I've been told by the other members of the Elite and other people I've heard from on Twitter. So it's kind of like The Walking Dead all over for me again. Now, will this hinder this experience? I don't think so, because what I've heard about this house, I'm extremely excited about it. And that's from somebody that doesn't even know anything about it. I'm even excited about Walking Dead this year, and that's not giving away its placement on my anticipated list, which is actually going to be another video you're going to get before I leave. But we'll get to that later. So we're going to see Lobster Boy, we're going to see the twins, Twisty's there, we're going to see Twisty's first killing at the picnic, the school bus in Jupiter, and all attention to detail has been paid, and you're going to go to the hotel after that. It's going to show you Stay on Main, which is the real-life LA hotel, which inspired Hotel Cortez. And they took some liberties in creating the hotel for the show. So basically, you're going to see serial killer guests, there's suicides, there's hauntings. That's all that happened in the Stay of Maine. That's their history of the actual hotel, which was leading to this season of American Horror Story Hotel. The Cortez section, very claustrophobic. Rows and rows of doors, probably very much like the elevator room in Insidious. If I had to guess, that's probably what I'm guessing. Anything could open at one time and come out and get you, or try to pull you into the door. We could possibly see that. Very interesting. And Murdy has promised that they're not going to bleed together. There's going to be clear beginning, middle, and ends to every single before we go into the actual next part of it. So we're going to get a transition that's not going to feel like muddied. It's basically going to feel like it's going to go from cohesively from one to the other, so one season to the next. And it says right now Murder House is the longest and Freak Show is the shortest, so that's also saying it's the flashiest part of the maze. Tons of detail, the Freak Show facade, obviously there. That's Hollywood. Let's go to Orlando real quick. Go back to a little bit of things about Orlando. Orlando will have three different facades. We're going to start out with the murder house, and we're going to shift into that very freak show facade, which looks pretty awesome from what I've seen in pictures. And ever since I saw the first picture of it, I was thinking, this has to come to Horror Nights. And we talked about it a long time ago, about a clown year where Jack would run the event, and we'd have killer clowns from outer space, and we'd have freak show, and we'd have, I know this is going to get me heat, but I don't really care, the Insane Clown Posse creating an original maze, probably in 3D. So yeah, it's going to be a very clown-heavy year. The clown saws roaming the park. I mean, I could totally see them doing that. But that was just, like, me speculating. but now it's actually going to happen. And it's going to happen in Soundstage 19. Now, Soundstage 19 is very interesting because it has never been used for Halloween Horror Nights before. And it is usually the place where Fox Sports does their stuff. And I know TNA has used that soundstage a time or two. Usually they do 20 or 21, but they have run 19. When they did a series of tapings in November and December, that was when AJ Styles left the company and when Jeff Hardy left the company the first time or like the 15th time. Anyway, it was basically, and I was in attendance with Joe for those shows, that was in Soundstage 19, and that's where it's going to be. American Horror Story will not be alone in Soundstage 19. No, because this year, based on how successful Legendary Truth was last year, we're getting to do something virtual reality again, and that brings up the repository. Now, I'm going to interest you in some interesting thoughts about the repository. This came out of absolute nowhere, and this was a blog post that was thrown out by TJ Manarino. And TJ basically said, this is a cutting-edge, terrifying virtual reality simulation, and it's going to blend the technology with real-life storytelling, bringing guests into the next dimension of horror experiences. Now, what this is, according to TJ, is this is one of the most electrifying projects he's ever worked on. It's the culmination of 8 years of experimental storytelling, drawing on feedback from the vast Horror Nights audience, and learning what thrills and chills them the very most. You're going to enter a psychological journey that's going to be very heart-pounding. It's going to be most personal. It's going to be very intense. You're going to encounter real-life characters and highly themed physical environments, working together in a team with three other people to uncover a paranormal mystery told through that cutting-edge technology. Now, we're going to set in a centuries-old warehouse where paranormal and supernatural artifacts have been collected and stored for hundreds of years. Now, recently, there is a secretive organization that has been behind this practice. They've installed some state-of-the-art technology, allowing spectral transportation into paranormal realms. Sounds to me like this is going to be quite legendary, if you will. So until now, the supernatural has infiltrated the world on occasions that were labeled mere hauntings. But for the first time ever, we're going to be sent across the spectral dark portal, the SDP, directly into those terrifying environments. So he basically warns us that whatever happens on the other side is irreversible, and that's the storyline we have. It's going to be $49.99 plus tax, and it's going to be purchased as one of the various upgrades we have for your Halloween Horror Nights ticket this year at the event. And it starts on September 29th and runs all the way until October 31st. I'll talk about the actual dates in a little bit. Now, if you want to purchase these, you can call a phone number, which is 1-407-224-7840, and numerous times are available throughout the evening, and they do sell out. I know for a fact that several ones have sold out, so if you're interested in the repository, check it out that way. That's not all. That's just what we heard to whet our appetite. Today, I found an article from yesterday that was posted on the Orlando Sentinel, and it was by Dwayne Bevel. And he gave us some new information. So, TJ elaborates. We're going to be in a group of four people, and we have to work together to solve a mystery. Each of us have a specific task we have to accomplish in order to make this work. It's kind of like Mission Space, but not quite. So, we're going to start in a real place, we're going to meet the characters, and then we're going to go into VR. And we're going to, after we've experienced our VR experience, we're going to take what we learned, what we've seen, what we experienced in the supernatural world, and we're going to put it together in order to solve the mystery. So you're going to be wearing head-mounted devices over your head. They're going to transport you into the paranormal realms. And they tried this, actually, with the Incredible Hulk coaster. Now, for those of you that got to do that, unfortunately I was not able to because I'm kind of stuck here for the time being, at least for now, I would say that it's not exactly the same. It's not the same headsets. It's not the same technology. So it's just a little bit of a taste of what you would come to expect from this experience. You're going to be able to walk around. You're going to inspect your surroundings. You're going to interact with and see the other three people that are in your group. how they react, what they do. It all becomes part of the show. It's very unique and different. There's going to be RFID technology, augmented reality. That's been worked on at the beginning. And then VR started about 18 months ago. And it's very interesting because last year, they did something quite legendary that I'm still not allowed to talk about. And yeah, there were some really incredible things. And I'll tell you right now, like I said before, like I said on Popcast, and I've been saying on Twitter, if this is even a third of what you have to expect from last year's rather legendary experience, then sign me up now. And we're already signed up. Like Tyler and I have already signed up for the 5:15 of September 29th, so we will be one of the first groups going into the event. I tried to get into the 5 o'clock. I personally got in the 5 o'clock, could not get Tyler into it. So we were basically told, show up early, and if there's room in the 5 o'clock, we will get in the 5 o'clock. If not, we'll be in the 5:15, which means we'll literally be one of the first two of the first eight people that are going to be able to experience the repository. And after we're done, we'll shoot you guys out a video and tell you what we can to try to get you excited about the repository, and hopefully you'll be able to experience it as well. I know the price point's a little bit steep, especially with the fact that it came in really late in the event, and it was after everything was already paid for, your hotel, your character dining, your RIP tour, your express pass, everything's already paid for. Here's another $50. So, I know a lot of people will probably be like, I don't know, but I'll tell you right now, I got a good feeling that if everything works out, then it's probably going to be something that everyone is going to want to experience, whether you're a fan of the event or you're someone that's just coming into the event. It's going to be something that you're going to want to spend time doing. So basically, the experience physically is going to take between 20 to 30 minutes. Now, the suggested time to block off is an hour and a half. Now, the reason why is because you're going to have to be there 30 minutes before. You're going to have to get your briefing, and you're going to find out about the technology. You're going to do the experience, and then at the end, just like with Legendary Truth last year, there's going to be a photo opportunity, and there's actually going to be a debriefing room where we can sit around and we can talk about the experience itself. I thought that was really cool because that's something I did not know was going to be the case. Until Dwayne posted this article, I did not realize that we were going to get a debriefing room. Now, what I can tell you about Legendary last year is the fact that the end of LT last year, and this is actually interesting because this kind of rolls us a little bit into another thing that's going on this year, was the place where the new Halloween Horror Nights tribute store is going to be held this year. So yeah, we had the Aftermath location for our Horror Nights store last year, and because Twister's gone bye-bye, yeah, obviously we have a new location. That location is over by Macy's, and that's going to be where your location's going to be. And if you did Legendary Truth last year, you know exactly what I'm talking about when I say this. The finale of Legendary Truth last year, without giving anything away, basically is going to be the location where your merch is going to be this year, like your big store for merch this year. So I wanted to mention that. So backtracking the repository, TJ basically said, this is not a 10th house, it's basically a new component to the event. That's his words here. He says, there's something that's really different. House elements, but also show elements, and now technology elements. So meshing all three of those together in a perfect package. I'm really excited about doing this. Cannot wait to experience the repository. And after what happened with Legendary Truth last year, which like I said, I cannot talk about, I will state that there's some really incredible things that I'm positive is going to happen with the repository. I did see in the actual disclaimer, I know that they're talking about the fact there's going to be simulated heights, so there's going to be all sorts of very interesting things. I'm just mind blown. I cannot wait for the repository. Sign me up right now. Yeah, as a matter of fact, you just did. Talk about annual pass holder event nights. It's finally out there. We have the RSVP, and we do have a couple new things about that this year that were not the case last year. So annual pass holder event nights, if you're not aware, the first two Fridays and Saturdays of Halloween Horror Nights 26, which is the 16th, the 17th, the 23rd, and the 24th. And you can RSVP, link in the description bar if you'd like to. It's going to get you into Tomb of the Ancients and Halloween Hell Comes to Haddonfield at 5:30 p.m. and the Texas Chainsaw Massacre at 5:45. It also gives you access to the first showing of Bill and Ted's Excellent Halloween Adventure. And something new for this year, for those of you that get in early, and we're going to get in early, obviously, if you're one of the first 100 people, you're going to get a special, apparently limited edition, because there's 100 people to get it a night, Halloween Horror Nights 26 Universal Orlando Annual Pass Holder bracelet. I don't know if it's going to be a band. I don't know if it's going to be like a slap band, because the Magical Tracking Bands was a couple years ago for Bill and Ted. But still, I mean, I want this. Anything Horror Nights related, I'll take it. Yep. I'll put it on my wrist. I'll wear it the entire event. So that proves it's like, oh, you got to go at the beginning of the event. Yes, I did. And I have the bracelet to show you. So yeah, that's what we're looking at right now. I know there was a lot of problems last year. There was a lot of problems with actual RSVPing for these four annual pass holder event nights, and a lot of people could not get more than one day. A lot of people were like, they started yelling about it and everything. But apparently it was a tech glitch, and sure enough, it was fixed, and you could sign up for as many days as you want. You didn't have to, like, just sign up for one. It's like, oh, no, you can only sign up for one this year. So, yeah, like, you're going to be able to go to all four if you want to. More information there. Character Dining's back this year. Back by popular demand, back at the Monsters Cafe once again. There's going to be interesting things. The menu this year is featuring sliced pork loin, chicken marsala, mashed potatoes and broccoli. There's vegetarian options, and there's salads, and of course there's desserts all the way from apple pie, key lime pie, to brookies. So, very interesting. There's going to be pictures with characters from most likely the various scare zones. I have a feeling there's going to be a lot of people from Chance and Hell, including Chance herself. It's going to be the only way, as of this moment, on property, you can get a photo with Chance. Yes, a Chance in this case. And it should be a really interesting way. If you want a picture with Chance, it's the only way to really get one, as of this moment, unless something changes. And I do think something will, because obviously The Last Laugh was uber successful last year, and I would love to take a chance on closing night in another environment back in Soundstage 33. Very happy to make that happen. Hopefully it does. Hopefully we'll find out more about that in the very near future, given the fact we are days away from the event. So, yeah, I mean, if you're able to do Character Dining, from what a lot of people have said, it's definitely worth it. It's, like I said, your only way to see Chance. For me, the menu is horrible. I don't think I could pay to eat chocolate cake and mashed potatoes and drink soda. Drink Celebrity Fizz while I do that. I mean, I don't know if that would be worth it or not, but I mean, just to be able to see Chance and to be able to see some characters. Most likely people from, I think probably people from Survivor Die will be in there since it's close by. I think there would definitely be people from Vamp 1955 in there. I don't know if there'll be anybody from Dead Man's Wharf or not. We do have Roaming Hordes this year, and I have a feeling we may see one or two of those. This year we have a lot of various things. We'll talk about that in another video. So yeah, there's been a lot of rumors about the Roaming Hordes. There's four this year, and yeah, there's some very interesting ones. Look out for some school spirit, if you will. Very bedazzling. You never know what Bubba's going to be around one corner, what Bubba's going to be around the other corner. Who knows? Maybe you might see a very familiar orange thing floating above your head. It's a possibility. Who knows? Maybe the Wizard of Oz might be in order to deal with some of these people. And surely but surely, there's some very interesting things that are possibly going to be in the streets this year. So yeah, we're going to be talking about that very soon. So yeah, I'm looking forward to the Roaming Hordes as well. That's on top of that. And the interesting thing about this is, if you want to go to Character Dining is only the 16th, 17th, 22nd, 23rd, and 24th, 29th, and 30th, October 1st, 6th through the 8th, 13th through the 15th, 20th through the 22nd, and the 27th through the 29th. That's the only days you're going to be able to do Character Dining this year. So yeah, I thought you guys might want to know a little bit more about that. And on top of that, we have the commercial. Yeah. We see a man scream. Find out he's kind of trapped in like what looks like this ginormous ballroom from a hotel or like a hotel corridor. He's like a chandelier high above. We hear, I believe it's Pagliacci. I might be wrong on that. Obviously, I was looking for it and I couldn't find it. So I was like, we got to get the video out. So I had to wait. We see Twisty. He's saying shh. And then we see Leatherface and the chainsaw with the way the makeup's done looks like Mrs. Doubtfire. We see three walkers from The Walking Dead. You see chain link fencing. You see Reagan's head spin, and it says, "Face horror beyond your wildest screams." This was our Coke commercial. This started a storm, legit, So much so that I think things changed than what they were going to be. Now, when this commercial was posted, Charles, a good friend of the Popcast Network and the birthday boy this year, today actually, honestly, happy birthday, Charles, I will state that he found this via another friend of the network, Morfan Scout, and he stayed up really late to capture this with a video on his television commercial. And it was the Coke commercial, and everybody was wondering, worst chance, worst chance, worst chance, and then it started to storm. There was outrage, and then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, we didn't really find out. This was going to be shared with Hollywood, and it was rumored a long time ago that Orlando had nothing to do with the commercial. It shows. And it was very, like, muted tones and everything. Felt very much like a Hollywood commercial. I wasn't a fan immediately. I was like, where's Chance? I don't know. Where's Myers, really? Where's Michael Myers? I don't understand. And where's Krampus? Like, yeah, you have your newest property of the year in Krampus, and you're not having Krampus in the commercial. Makes no sense. Myers made sense to be in the commercial. That made me think, oh, there's going to be another commercial that was going to be released on the West Coast with Freddy, Jason, Michael, and Leatherface that's going to be on there. And nope, that didn't happen either. It's going to be the same commercial. So Hollywood posted that officially on their Facebook page, and that was the end of that. Our outrage continued, and eventually we got the official commercial. It was released on the YouTube channel, released on the Twitter page, and it said about the same thing. Instead of Reagan's head spinning, we saw Reagan levitating high above, and the next thing you know, we kind of snapped quick to a jump cut where we see Chance there, and she screams, and that's the end. Oh my god. Well, let me get up here. Sorry about that. The thing about it is, honestly, I think I understand why Chance is not in the commercial. I don't like it. I don't have to like it. I'm not going to like it. But I'm glad that they put her in there. It feels a little bit tacked on, but hopefully that was their plan all along, and that wasn't just, oh, hey, they complained. Hey, no, just put her in front of a green screen, and let's do this. But no, recut the commercial and put it out the next day. So, who knows what's going to happen. Just mere minutes ago, something even better was posted on the Halloween Horror Nights Orlando Facebook page, and it was a link to 4 videos. Short, seconds-long videos of Chance. The headline said, Dare to Enter, and then the ellipses, and then it's, you have Chance there, and she says, you won't stand a chance. The next video, ... Chance's mind, run all you want, as she transforms reality, ... pans up the body from the boots to the fishnets all the way to the dress. And of course, it's kind of like morphing back and forth between like the dominatrix style outfit and obviously like the straight jacket. And she says, with the thing that I love very much and the one thing I really want to see on a t-shirt this year more than anything, that was the fact that you had her tilt her head when she pops the light bulb in the actual promo video, and she says, do you think I'm pretty? And just then it said, to a surreal theater of madness, and then you see her standing on the black and white checkerboard ground, which is going to be what she's going to be standing on in the actual scare zone, Chance in Hell. And it says, now I'm taking center stage. That right there, if you would utilize that in the commercial, I totally would have liked that more. I know the IP sell the event. I totally understand that. I know the general public are what they're trying to market to. I understand that people want to see Reagan. They want to see Leatherface. They want to see Texas. They want to see, hey, Twisty is in there too, obviously. So they want to see that. Where's Krampus? Like I said before, why is Krampus not in the commercial? Michael Myers, doesn't make any sense. Why is Michael Myers not in the commercial? We had so many great ideas for the commercial, and they decided they want to do something else. But like I said, I don't completely blame Orlando because it's not their fault. I'd say right now that basically this is Hollywood and Hollywood only. If you want to put any heat on anybody for the commercial, I'd throw the heat on the West Coast. So yeah, that's, or the East Coast. I don't know how it works. Like, that's the West Coast, that's the East Coast. Anyway, to the window, to the wall. Now the thing is, I wasn't a fan of the commercial, but I understood. But it's a lot better now. At least a little bit of Chance is better than none at all. So she is our icon. I wish they would pay attention to that. I understand that that's just for us, not for the general public. But that's a story for a different time. So I guess your video for this week. I will announce right now, like I said before, we have 8 Halloween Horror Nights 26 meetups that are going to be taking place during the duration of Halloween Horror Nights 26. And the elite of the Popcast Network are going to be available throughout the entire event, outside of meetups to just hang out and chat with people and be able to go through mazes, go see Bill and Ted, and all sorts of various things, go through scare zones, just hang out in the parks, outside the parks. All that stuff's going to be available if you want to attend any of the 8 meetups. I will tell you right now, we're going to be going to some Chocolate Emporium and Savory Feast Kitchen. That's going to be on September 24th. After that, we're going to move over to Halloween Horror Nights for that night. That's going to be starting at 1 p.m. And on the 30th, we're going to go to Islands of Adventure for the day, and then we're going to go over to Halloween Horror Nights. If you go to the park, it's going to be 11 a.m. We're going to start various times throughout the day, pick up people along the way, as we probably are going to take the Hogwarts Express over to the studios, which makes sense in this case. If something happens, we can't do that with everyone in the group. We can possibly just walk through City Walk as a group. Might be really fun to see that. And October 1st, we're going to be doing Galaxy Bowl at Cabana Bay Beach Resort. That's going to be at 11 a.m. Then we're going to go over to Universal for a little bit and be there for Halloween Horror Nights that night. October 7th, we're going to be doing mini golf. We're going to be doing the Hollywood Drive-In Golf Course, the horror-themed course. That's going to be at 2 p.m. and then Halloween Horror Nights that night. And then on the 15th, the sequel is going to be the sci-fi course of Hollywood Drive-In Golf. And that's going to be at 2 p.m. as well, then Halloween Horror Nights that night. October 29th, the goodbye to Halloween Horror Nights 26 weekend. We're going to go to Universal Studios all day, then we're going to go over to Halloween Horror Nights that night, and then on October 30th, we're going to go back to Toothsome where it all started, and then we're going to do Bill and Ted, the first and last shows of the night, and also experience the various high spots from Halloween Horror Nights 26. So that's the meetups. Link in the description bar below for the RSVP information, or hit me up on Twitter if you do not have Facebook, or if you don't have any other social media, then just get at me somehow, and we can leave a comment on this video, or you can also email me, sirowanddisney@gmail.com, if you'd like to do that. Tweet me at sirowanddisney, tweet the network at Popcast Network. Links in the description bar for all the elite of the Popcast Network, all our YouTube channels, all our social medias, and all the information about us, and also about some great Halloween Horror Nights content that's available online, from podcasts all the way to message boards and all points in between. So, that being said, I want to thank you guys and girls out there for watching. We do have one more Halloween Horror Nights 26 related video to do before I get to town next Wednesday. And hopefully I'll have a big announcement about that video. It will be where I officially announce the anticipation list. And for those of you that listened to the podcast where I gave my anticipation list, there is a slight possibility some of that changed. And we're going to be talking about all the scare zones, and we're going to be talking about the roaming hordes. We have a map that has been released, which we now know the locations to everything now. So we're going to be giving that information. That's going to take place in another video. Hollywood fans, we still got to talk about Eli Roth's Terror Tram and the anticipation list for Hollywood. That's coming up later this week. Hopefully we'll have that up sometime this weekend. And that's your video. So once again, I want to thank you guys and girls out there for watching. I'll see some of you in the fog this year. And until tomorrow, boys and girls, that's all I got to say about that.